inside. Tim Talbot reaches back. And that is whistled down, and nobody is happy now as in came Gagne with a late poke. And look out as Talbot is into it, and he wants a piece of somebody back there.
Gagne's coming back at Giordano, and now Giordano's coming up too. This thing blew over in a hurry.
And Smith is coming up to center ice as this thing comes unglued.
And Bear in the high slot here fighting, looks like with Matthew Tkachuk.
It's Tkachuk and Bear, and they are trading them. Bear comes over the top of the right. Tkachuk comes back, and now Talbot and Mike Smith are going to go as center ice. Talbot and Smith, who've been on both sides of this Battle of Alberta. This is unbelievable.
Wow. Both guys played for the other team respectively the year before in the Battle of Alberta. They're going against each other. And Mike Smith came right to center. Talbot said, you know what, let's do this. And shrapnel on the ice right there.
It is a yard sale out there, and the people in this building can't believe what they just saw.
Well, there it is there, and Talbot lays down on his back, and it was underneath him, but Gagne jams through under the armpit. They take exception, everybody comes in, including Talbot, and then a couple shots unanswered by Gagne on Giordano. He looks like he gets up, and he's not too happy about that, and then Tkachuk separates with Bear, and they go out and had a pretty good doozy tilt, too. Both of them got some shots in. Ethan Bear's first scrap in the NHL. With this thing, that three-goal lead, we talked about it. Could this thing boil over with the history this year, especially carried over from last year in the Battle of Alberta? And then, you know what? Mike Smith standing in center, and Cam Talbot looks up the ice and says, you know what? Let's keep this thing going. And they go at it, had a pretty spirited tilt, too. Two big guys, too. You look at both of these guys off the ice. They're not your typical goaltenders. Talbot's a big dude, took a couple rights there. He comes back with one, and then as they go down, good job by Smith to pull up and not continue to wail away. But two big guys off the ice, too. They have at it, too. But obviously, yeah, we're going to see a couple different goaltenders in between the pipes for both teams.
Watching with the opportunity there. Now watch what happens right there. A left shot to the chin of Roberto Luongo. Dustin Byfuglien got in too tight. He was trying to settle down a rolling puck.
And the conversation has continued as now O'Brien, who's one of their tough guys, now Eager's going to drop the glove. Eager and Bieksa. And a couple of others have paired off. Seabrook, oh, and Eager, a big left-hand drop. Bieksa. Bieksa looking to answer as the officials are occupied elsewhere. And this one's going to keep going. Eager and Bieksa. And now one of the referees comes over. That's Mike Hassenfratz. Here's Duncan Keith along with Burroughs. And they have just about all paired up. Burroughs seemed to have a head full of hair.
I think Adam Burroughs has got to get away from the linesman and get over where Duncan Keith and Burroughs is.
Look at that, he's pulling his hair. Burroughs. And there are too many altercations and too few officials here. Well, we told you it was a big game and it was going to be an intense game, and it's spilling over here early in the third. Combatants were Eager and Bieksa, but there were a couple of bouts on the undercard as well.
Right before this all started.
A goaltender.
No question. Well, there Brent Seabrook does a nice job of getting in the way of Shane O'Brien, and then Bieksa and Eager start going at it. Look at Bieksa's right arm. He couldn't get it free. And then a quick left right to the jaw of Kevin Bieksa. And then while that was happening on, Duncan Keith and Alex Burroughs went at it. Now, with everything going on, they were trying to watch everything there. which fight started first?
With under a minute to go, it's hooked in front. Puck is loose. Bishop gets out to handle it. Now we got Richards grabbed as he went after Schuster. Advocator running in there, and there's a few members of the Lightning running to take a number. Advocator firing punches. He got out of the bottom of that pile. Two members of the Lightning were anxious to get on him.
I'm not sure who's on the bottom of the pile there on the receiving end of some of those applicator punches.
Nesterov firing some punches.
And that's Callahan tackling Larkin and pulling him off the bottom. Off the top of that pile.
Nesterov going after Richards. And Nesterov lands the takedown for a few more right hands.
And it was Richards who started it. Oh, I think it's Schuster. Schuster must be at the bottom of that. Abdelkader was throwing punches at him. From what I could see, Richards was frustrated because Schuster had him covered really well in front of the net, was strong on his stick. Now, if he was holding his stick, maybe that's why Richards got upset. But right after the whistle went, Richards took a shot at Schuster, and then everything went from there.
Yeah, he gave him a pretty good two-hander.
Oh, Blunden was in there. Blunden's bloody. So maybe he was the one then that abdicated. It was hard to tell. Schuster was at the bottom of the pile, and it looks like Blunden was too. So that's why, yeah, now Blunden wants a piece of him now. Like, okay, we're both standing up now. Let's go. Come on. Blunden's no stranger to this. Abdicator's been a fighter in his time as well. But when you're already down, oh, Blunden is hot, and you can see why. He's bloodied. And he was down, and Abdelkader had the big-time advantage there and was throwing some haymakers.
McAvoy with it. On the circle, cranks it. Save, Vasilevsky. Puck leaked free for a moment. Worked off the goal line there by Point. The referees say no goal. The crowd celebrating what they think is a goal, but Point got there. Here comes Kucherov. Chara's back. Kucherov cuts in. Spun around as the play goes to the corner. And there's the siren sounding as apparently the situation room has contacted the off-ice officials, the penalty timekeepers, and holding play. But we're not done. Maroon and Chara separated by the linesman in here, but every player on the ice, save for the goalies, are going at it. Chernak and McAvoy. Chernak's got the gloves off. McAvoy turtling. Delorme's involved.
Crawley came off the bench there and jumped on Killorn. So now he's got linesmen in between them. Chara is hot, and he's with Maroon. They fought before, remember. Big time reach advantage there for Chara.
And down goes Chara. Maroon takes him down. Boy, they fought a number of times, haven't they?
Yeah, and then Maroon just led him back up after. He had to get leverage there. When Chara gets that arm locked out, there's nobody in the league who can swing their arms like he can. But it's about leverage and knowing what you're doing. Maroon knew he had to stand up to him because he had called him on earlier on in the season. So Chara wanted a piece of him this time. Maroon was able to take him down, and everything else gets settled out along the way too. But boy, this is bedlam here in this game now.
Meantime, they're checking whether that puck crossed the line. It looked like Point got there.
It did. That's why they blew the siren. The goal is in. They wouldn't have blown the siren in the middle of play if they hadn't looked at it. Here's what happened afterwards. But here's the goal. It goes right through Vasilevsky, and they looked at it, and it's definitely in. So that's why the play went on. And as it was coming back through the neutral zone, they sounded the siren because they looked at it in Toronto, and Crawley knew it was in. They could tell, even though the referee is waving it off. And then that's when the bedlam broke up. Well, here's the Bruins coming out of the zone, and then the siren goes, because that's when Toronto phoned in and said, it's a goal. Well, you know, sound the siren. And in the neutral zone, there's the original confrontation, and I'm guessing a conversation between Maroon and Chara, going back to earlier in the season when Maroon called Chara on, and Chara obliged him.
1:23, the puck completely crossed the goal line.
Boy, there's electricity here tonight. Hennigan behind the net, plays the puck into the corner. Then Chase misses a check from Cummins, drops his glove. Chase and Jim Cummins. Cummins, a first year player out of college, and Chase. Cummins throws a right that misses. Chase grabs him. They're going to let him go. The referee, Dan Mariwelli, taking care of all the other players, telling them to go to center ice. Cummins and Chase really going at it. In the corner, and Chase certainly holding his own, getting some good cuts in on the 22-year-old out of Michigan State, Jim Cummins. Now they're up against the boards. Chase with his back to the glass. But Cummins not getting anything really free. Chase strong, tough, and Chase has proven in his NHL career as a fighter to be very durable. Boy, they're still going. They've got to be exhausted by now. Oh, and Cummins missed with a roundhouse right. And Chase got in a swing, and Cummins went flying to the ice. They're on their feet at the arena. Just 54 seconds into the game, Kelly Chase and Jim Cummins get into a great fight. Now Probert's going to go with Lowry. Everybody goes. Then Zombo and McCrimmon. And everybody pairs up. It's out of control. McCrimmon's down on the ice. Zombo. Here comes Cheveldae. He'll be thrown out of the game. Cheveldae. Now Joseph gets into it. Curtis Joseph grabs Cheveldae, and the two goalies go at it head to head, and Joseph with three great rights to Cheveldae. And we've got some terrific fights going on.
And Cummins came out of the penalty box as well.
There are sticks and gloves everywhere. The two goalies, great fight at center ice. For those of you watching that on television, we'll try to update you on everyone else. Dan Mariwelli has Cummins out of things. The two linesmen are working on separating Lowry and Probert. Bassin is out there tied up with one of the wing's players. And now I guess fatigue setting in a bit. Holy cow, what a way to begin a night of hockey here at the arena in St. Louis. Listen to this crowd.
To McCarty. Here is Larionov. Avalanche holding the Red Wings in their own zone. Larionov and Forsberg away from the play. Peter Forsberg took a swipe at Igor Larionov. And it isn't often that we see Igor Larionov go, but he did. And now Darren McCarty gets his shots in at Claude Lemieux. And look who came all the way out to try to help. Patrick Waugh. My goodness. You never know when to expect it, Darren McCarty said before. Vernon and Waugh. Mike Vernon with a great left. Follows up with the right. How about this? Lemieux was hammered by Darren McCarty, and he is being helped into the locker room. Two of the best of all time, known for the use of the pillows, Vernon and Waugh square off. They are on their feet here at Joe Louis Arena. 301 days since the hit on Chris Draper. And look at Darren McCarty. Patrick Waugh bloodied up. Peter Forsberg bloodied up. And Lemieux in the locker room. It starts with Forsberg and Igor Larionov. Forsberg with an extra hit to the head. And Igor objects. And he gets the headlock on Peter Forsberg. And then, away from that, Patrick Waugh and Mike Vernon. Patrick Waugh came out to aid Claude Lemieux. And look at the goalies go. And And Patrick Roy has a heck of a size advantage. And Claude Lemieux, he was hammered by Darren McCarty. McCarty came in, and he went after Claude Lemieux. Took the helmet off and got a shot or two in. And that's when Waugh came to Lemieux's rescue. And look at who stepped in on Patrick Waugh. Brendan Shanahan. Welcome back to old-time hockey. Now here's how Darren got loose. And he got the shot in at Claude Lemieux. And from there, pandemonium. Look at the goalie's battle. You gotta be tough and a little crazy to stop pucks traveling over 100 miles an hour. And they are tough in more ways than one. Mike Vernon and Patrick Waugh.